Adobe and Intel, in my 26 years here, have had a very tight relationship, especially with the pro video team and the imaging team.
Intel has deep engagement with Adobe on multiple fronts, them being the flagship product for creator segment. We have been working with them for quite a few years and delivering solutions that work well for creator users on Intel architecture.
Content creators typically are multitaskers, and they're trying to work as fast as their minds can keep up.
There is rendering going on in background if you look at the creator segment, and then people want to do photo editing in the foreground or apply different filters or effects. They want their system to be responsive in all cases.
The After Effects team has been working for about the last 8 years to bring a new level of multi-core rendering to the processor.
On Alder Lake Desktop S series, we have 8 P cores or performant cores and 8 E cores or efficient cores. The performant cores are there to give advantage to limited threading, single threading usage scenarios that many of the creator usages such as Adobe can benefit from. And then we have our Atom multi-threaded efficient cores that can provide multi-threaded efficiency and performance also to all the different use cases that we have in the market.
Intel Thread Director allows us to dedicate those processing cores to the apps that matter that are doing the creation, while at the same time I can keep everything open, look at my notes, look at the internet, whatever it is I need to do, knowing that those are going to go to those efficiency cores. So again, it is a whole new way of thinking with these processors.
Multi-frame rendering is one of the features in After Effects that the team working at Intel has worked on with Adobe extensively.
So with multi-frame rendering, you can actually work faster, get more additions out for those editors and for those compositors to review when you're working in a team environment, and you can really work as fast as your mind.
So really, it's a twofold benefit coming from the scaling that we get with added cores, as well as the microarchitectural enhancements because of larger caches, instruction per cycle gain, and overall microarchitecture benefit.
I think the digital content creator that uses both Adobe and Intel has a lot to look forward to with this next gen processor. I can't wait to see what's next.